What's the greenest energy source? If I were to ask you, what's the greenest, lowest carbon source of energy, what would your answer be? Would it be hydropower, wind, solar? Those are all good answers. Renewable energy sources are some of the best around when it comes to environmental friendliness. Nobody's disputing that fact. And they will all play extremely important roles in our future energy mix. But while they may be among the best, they are not the best. So, what is the greenest, lowest carbon source of energy? If you want green energy, go for the green rock. The United Nations Economic Commission for Europe recently released a new report that caught my attention. It details the entire life cycle of the various electricity generation options available to the European countries. Based upon their extensive data collection and calculations, they've crowned nuclear power as the king of green energy. Nuclear has the lowest average carbon emissions throughout its entire life cycle. That's the chart you're looking at right now, which is the life cycle, the greenhouse gas emissions per kilowatt hour of electricity generations. Now, if you're familiar with nuclear energy, you know that it's not as easy as it sounds. You know it's not as simple as digging up rocks from underground and chucking them into a nuclear reactor. Besides the actual mining operation, you need to refine the uranium from the ore. This is to turn that raw uranium ore into usable fissible material. That's before you get to the nuclear reactors themselves, which tend to be fairly complicated and costly to build. Don't forget the disposal of the radioactive waste at the other end. On top of all that, you need to factor in transportation required to get all the materials from point A to point B. Yes, you might be thinking, surely, with all that taken into account, there's no way nuclear energy still comes out on top, right? But as expected of the UN, they don't do things by halves. Every aspect of the power generation life cycle for every source has been considered. And everything listed above was taken into account when they were calculating the life cycle greenhouse gas emissions of nuclear power. Don't forget, it's not as if renewable energy sources are magical cure-alls to the green energy problem either. Hydro dams can have a devastating impact on local ecosystems with their large reservoirs, which, by the way, also generate carbon dioxide and methane from the decomposing vegetation submerged underneath the waters. While all power generation requires copper for cabling and infrastructure, solar power needs more of it than any of the others for all the electrical equipment. Wind power is relatively more reliant on steel and chromium in the construction of the wind turbines. And of course, there's no escaping the emissions from transporting all the materials involved in building up all these power sources either. Nuclear energy isn't the only source of power generation with hidden carbon emissions in its life cycle. It just gets the worst press. Low emissions aren't the only thing about nuclear energy. From an environmental impact point of view, greenhouse gas emissions are just one part of the picture. Climate change is at the forefront of everybody's mind right now when it comes to environmental friendliness, but there are other factors to consider as well, such as land and water use, ecosystem impact, negative effects on human health, and the consumption of non-replenishable resources. There are lots of dynamics at play when it comes to considering and quantifying the total impact of a power plant. But when you tally up all those metrics, look who's showing up at the top again. This is a chart right from the UNEC report that was just published. You got it. When considering all of the life cycle impacts and not just the greenhouse gas emissions, nuclear not only comes very close to first, it comes in third. But when compared to which are first and second, you can kind of defer that nuclear power is the largest in the rankings. That's because it's just behind small-scale hydro plants and are almost on par with the tower-type concentrated solar plants. That's a great result for your nuclear power, especially when you consider that hydropower plants are much more restrictive in terms of where you can build them. It should be clear that nuclear power wins on just about all fronts, besides marketing. For all the NGOs, climate champions, and advocates, please take note. Over the past half century, nuclear power has mitigated around 74 gigatons of CO2 emissions. That's the equivalent nearly to 2 full years' worth of emissions from all energy production around the world. The UNECE has gone as far to say that, and I quote, international climate objectives will not be met if nuclear power is excluded. I don't think it gets any clearer than that. Uranium is the cool kid again. With nuclear power back coming into vogue, that means the uranium frenzy is on. The last uranium bull market saw explosive, and some may say radioactive, returns for those who play their cards correctly. Now that we're on the cusp of another major run-up in uranium prices, you'll want to make sure you're backing the right companies with the right management teams, with the right assets in the right jurisdictions. After all, for every success story the last uranium bull market saw, there was many failures that were forgotten about. Thousands upon thousands of acres of land were snatched up, much of it little more than moose pasture in vaguely right area, highly promoted. When the world finally realizes that nuclear is the only option they have left if they want to meet their climate change objectives, they'll have no choice but to turn to uranium. And when that happens, the exact same story will play out again. The Johnny-come-latelys will pile onto the uranium bandwagon, leaving you to sift through the rubbish to find the gems. It's a story I'm intimately familiar with, and I'm ready to do it again, this time with my Catoosa Resource Opportunity subscribers along for the ride. Stay safe. Subscribe to the KRO, which is a Catoosa Resource Opportunities, to find out exactly what prices I'm buying at and what price I sell at before the trade occurs. And you get to sell before I do. If you want to give your portfolio an edge, consider becoming a member and giving it a try for yourself.